Right. I'm with Largs Academy. I'll hand the phone over to you. With Largs Academy, students and teachers and head teacher today at the Big Count. First of all, Heather, would you like to say a few words? How have you enjoyed the experience and what do you think all the pupils here can learn from it?
I think the pupils are learning a lot and they're teaching me a lot about what about a spoiled paper looks like. They've just been in to tell me there about what it means. So I think we're learning a lot. It's really interesting being here and it's quite a nice, calm atmosphere, but I don't know as the night goes on whether that will be maintained. I'm just not too sure.
I think this is a night that Scotland doesn't sleep, it would appear.
Almost as exciting as Andy Murray winning Wimbledon.
Me and you could definitely agree on that one, being tennis fans. And what about yourself? Sorry, what's your name? Sorry,
I'm Mrs. Scott, teacher of history and modern studies.
For modern studies, oh well, this is. In your opinion, where does this stand in terms of modern history in Scotland?
Scotland's making history today, and you know, the young people, I'm incredibly proud of how they've conducted themselves, their excitement, their engagement in this whole referendum protest has been absolutely fantastic.
Well, what do you think as well, just to say, in terms of it is such a seismic decision tonight, do you think the children, I mean, when we were these pupils' ages, we never had this opportunity. What do you think yourself about the children getting the chance to vote as well?
I think it's been the best thing that's happened for them.
And you think we'll take that in future?
The legacy will be the engagement of young people in politics.
Right. Now, I'm right in saying Zoe?
Yeah.
Zoe McIntyre. what have you taken from tonight, and what legacy do you think it will have for you in future as a teenager and the local community councillor?
Well, I want to do politics when I go to uni, so it's the result. It could affect my political career in two separate ways, so who knows, but I think it's just been great because 2 years ago I was decided, and if I had tried to talk to people about it, people would have probably told me to go away, I'm not interested. But now everybody's talking about it and everybody's interested, so it's just great for me because it's what I'd really like to see in society as a whole, never mind just young people.
Fantastic, so thank you. And over to the guys now. You just thought you weren't going to get a word in there, didn't you? What do you think of it so far? It's interesting to see we've got some yes and we've got some no, so it's very balanced amongst the pupils, which makes it a lot easier from my point of view. But what do you think of tonight, and what do you think you could take from it? What's your name, first of all?
Jamie Farrell. Yep.
What do you think of tonight?
I think it's been really exciting, and seeing everyone getting engaged in politics as well. And I think it's set a good precedent for young people and for the old people to see that we are competent in politics and we know and we understand what's going on. And I think it sets a good precedent for future, for maybe lowering the voting age. Because my personal view is that at 16 we can get married, we can have jobs and pay taxes, so why shouldn't we have the vote? And I think this sets a good precedent for that, showing that we're competent, we understand, rather than just voting emotionally.
That's great. Okay, thanks very much, James. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. I'll ask Emily as well. Anyway, what would you say from tonight? What have you learnt from tonight? What are you expecting? Because we still haven't heard the result.
I think from tonight, I just think no matter the outcome, I think it's just incredible that all of us have had the chance to be involved in something so momentous and something that could change the course of history. It's just incredible.
Yeah. I think that's the way a lot of us feel, actually, isn't it? And do you think, in terms of getting the school down here, getting the whole, having your classmates here, having you know the teachers here, modern studies, the head teacher, it's quite special to have that involvement rather than just the politicians. It's a really interesting time, isn't it?
Yeah, I really like the fact that we've had the chance to be involved in so many of these things, like going to the big debate and all the different kind of things that we've had to do. It's just been incredible to be involved in it all.
And I'm gonna push you. What do you think it's gonna be tonight?
Honestly, I think it's gonna be a no vote, but I'm hopeful. But I do. had my doubts.
Okay. And very lastly, do you think this has been a victory for democracy tonight?
Definitely. I think that's the one thing I'm really pleased about, is to see young people actually take an interest in politics. That's got to be worth it, hasn't it?
Absolutely.
They've needed something to get their teeth into and start thinking about, and it's really given them something to think about.
Yeah, right.
And that's what you're saying, Gillian.
Yeah, absolutely.
A legacy.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. That's what it's all about, and that's why we're all here tonight. And let's say, I can't recall anything like it in all my time. And
I've never heard such sensible debates. When we come back from the thing at Eastwood the other night there, the kids in the bus talked politics with Mrs. Scott all the way back. Uh-huh. I mean, it was question after question, discussion, debate. They were having a really heated debate about it, and that's just so interesting. And it's great to hear young people be able to do that. I couldn't have done that at that age.